This is a payload that's going to be on the GEM exposed module, so it's hanging on the outside of the ISS looking down at the Earth. And what are we doing? We're trying to measure atmospheric carbon dioxide. Plants are actually doing us a huge favor. Those plants in the ocean take about half of the atmospheric carbon dioxide that humans emit out every year. But some years it's 20%, some years it's 80%, and we've got to figure out why that is. So OCO2 has started collecting atmospheric carbon dioxide data. We've been doing that since 2014. OCO3 is meant to continue that record of carbon dioxide and build on to what OCO2 started. But being on the space station is a little bit different. You know, it's in this precessing orbit. Every day it goes over your head a little bit earlier in the day. We'll have these detailed little snapshot maps of carbon dioxide and SIF that are unlike data we've collected before. Let us see new things about forests, crop areas, and of course there's folks want to look at cities and power plants. So the snapshot map's going to be a great new way to get a detailed picture of carbon dioxide.
We're interested in studying planetary bodies. So in particular, my researcher focus is on studying asteroids. The goal of Hermes is to study the surface material of asteroids, and this is something that we call regolith, this fine particles, fine dust that covers the entire surface. There's a lot of interest in one day sending astronauts to asteroids, for instance, and we have already sent a lot of robotic missions to asteroids and plan to send more. And so we need to understand how to interact with the asteroid surface. So if you're going to anchor to the surface of the asteroid, for instance, you need to understand how to interact with the regolith. Why do we want to study this on the ISS? So it's not just the long duration exposure in microgravity, it's also something that we have on asteroids is vacuum, right? So we want to expose our experiments to the vacuum of space. So we actually have our facility hooked up essentially to a port to space. So this will be a permanent facility on the space station. And the idea is that we'll send different science packages that are called cassettes that will go inside the facility. So we did cassette one, but the idea is that Hermes will be open to other investigators. So cassette two, cassette three, cassette seven, these will be other researchers that will apply to use Hermes to do research on asteroid regolith and granular material investigations.
This is a tiny bioengineered device that contains living human cells that are designed to recreate the structure and function of your tissues in your body. So we see tissue chips as a tool to help understand diseases and speed the process of drug discovery, which down here on Earth right now is extremely expensive and takes a really, really long time. We're using microgravity also as a tool because, as you know, microgravity causes changes in physiology in astronauts that often seem to mimic what's quite similar to some disease states or aging here on Earth. That happens on a really short timescale. So we're essentially able to speed up the whole process of disease modeling and testing of drugs by using these tissue chips up on the space station. So that's a big win down for us here on Earth. All of these technological advances and the problems that the teams have had to encounter to shrink their technology and make it really robust is going to be transformational for the technology back down here on Earth, because it's going to make this technology much more broadly accessible to a wider audience who can use it down here on Earth. So we have four projects that are launching. We have a team from the University of Washington who is going to be sending up a kidney chip.
We're actually sending up 24 of these chips to the International Space Station. So that's 72 individual tubules. Not only is the kidney very important for filtering our blood and removing waste products via urine, but it's also a key organ involved in the synthesis of a number of different hormones and vitamins. One of those vitamins is vitamin D. And so we actually hope to learn in a matter of a course of weeks is how does osteoporosis via vitamin D metabolism occur in a disease which typically takes place over the course of years, if not decades.
We are the 2018 Genes in Space winning team. So if you're unfamiliar with Genes in Space, it's a 7th to 12th grade DNA competition where you design an experiment to take place on the International Space Station.
DNA is the blueprint of life, right? So it encodes all our genetic information, and it gets transcribed to RNA, which is translated to proteins, which of course help all of our cells function. Astronauts undergo high radiation from HC ions or galactic cosmic rays, which can lead to these double-stranded breaks. So our objective in this experiment was to examine how repair pathway frequencies and double-stranded break repair as a whole are affected by microgravity. So to test our hypothesis, we're going to be using the CRISPR-Cas9 system.
We want to verify that Cas9 can cut in space and that we can deduce repair pathway frequencies based on the resulting sequences. So the results of these experiments could help set the stage for genomic editing in space and protect astronauts from intense radiation experienced in flight.